I'm having this problem where I can't log in to the system with the SIL policy. So it's kind of weird because it all looks pretty decent to me. So I basically have this policy. It's basically all in one file, most of it in one file. And basically I set up a couple types. System T is the main process type, unlabeled T for the unlabeled initial security identifier, file T for the file initial security identifier, security for the security initial security identifier, then a single role, actual role, and then basically allow the role access to the associate the role to the system underscore T type, the sole process type, so to speak, except the unlabeled ISID type. And then basically I create a type attribute, all my types, and then I basically make systemd unconfined by allowing it to access to all the all my type types full access using the all permission sets. So that's all fine. And then basically I also do this dance the object R associate the object R role to the all my types. Basically that's a prerequisite, I guess. And so basically, and then you have the SID context, which basically are all unconfined T except for system T for basically kernel, and security T for security, and unlabeled T for unlabeled, and file for file. And the remainder is unlabeled. So yeah, that setup. Actually, devnil is also set to system T. That's wrong. That's actually wrong. That needs to be unlabeled T. Yeah, right, the SID. Yeah, that's supposedly everything. Oh, actually, no, that's not the case. Sorry, systemd. Basically, everything is systemd except the unlabeled and the deprecated ones. And everything else is system and has its private type. Anyways, then I basically put all the GenFS cons, the FSU strands cons, and the FSUse task cons and stuff like that, so that stuff is labeled. And then basically a file con for the root and all the files below, basically all the same, all that single type. So basically I have just a couple types, two roles actually with object R included, and then a single as Linux user identity. And then I have a port con, two port cons for TCP and UDP, which also for system T, so it's also single type. And then basically I have a single user here, test U, and basically associate the role to the user, to the type. And create a user prefix here, and basically add a role to the user identity, and set a user level and a user range. And then I use these two. I've been playing a little bit. I'm not sure if this works. Actually, I couldn't get this to work. And I also added that with the MCS declarations. The MCS is set to true, so I'm building MCS currently. And I just added these high and lows there. And then the low high keywords, I guess they are. So not sure if this is correct, but it doesn't seem to work anyways. If I understand it correctly. And then the initial SIDs and stuff like normal, and then the access vectors basically, and the all class perms basically. Added the systemd permissions, and yeah, the systemd permissions, and then basically this rules, these macros from to make the object R stuff workaround work. And policy capabilities, added these in for open perms and network peer controls. And then basically a shell script that basically copies a bunch of files. And yeah, that's it seems to work. So basically what I'm getting is, if I basically go to that system, so I can boot up fine. It boots in the enforcing mode, and it would boots up fine. Let's see where I have the shell. Yeah, here. So, for example, there are no role allow rules because, well, there's this single role, actually, with the object R role excluded, but there's only the test R role, I guess. And then I run the XR to see which roles have access to which types or are associated to which types. So test R is associated to system T and object R is associated to all the types here. And then I have a look at the users. If the user is set up properly and test U, now default level F0 and a full range. And then the two roles associated. And if I run SU manage login list, then these are listed. And that's because of the files that I installed with this with that script, the test script. Basically, this is what's there. And then there's a single SU Linux user setup. Now, so as you can see here from the mapping, root is mapped to test U. And test U is mapped to test R. So, and these are the roles. And so basically, if I basically do a SE Linux DEFCON, and then root, and then test U, test R, and then system T as 0, then it just says command not found. Now, either I'm just stupid or incompetent, or but I was expecting some output here. And this is default got Fedora. This is a stock Fedora 20 system, so yeah, PAM and stuff should just work. And but anyways, so there's no context return, and if I do a SE Linux con list, root test U test R. And then system T at 0, then nothing gets returned at all. So it's kind of weird. I mean, and basically, as you can see, as you search allow and then source system T, it pretty much has full access. But the weird thing is that. And that might be actually a Fedora fix or something like that. That doesn't actually expand any of these types. It just shows the attributes, and which is fine. And it seems to work, as far as I'm concerned. And let's see if direct, if that changes anything. So it seems to not expand for some reason. Which is kind of weird, but it still works because I can just show you that basically that's the last thing I'll show you actually then. So basically, let's just log in, and then I'll show you what happens. So basically, when I log in, ABC123. So I'm getting an unable to get valid context for root. And you saw earlier, oh actually, yeah, that's with test R, and I can also do it with without test R, same result. See, unable to get valid context, but I'm in permissive mode currently, because else I can't log in. So, but anyways, if I do a journal, let's just first do a out search, user, AVC, AVC, and then SELinux error, and then TS recent. You can see that it's just clean. It's just totally clean, and the message also just totally clean. Everything is fine. These are the last two times that I logged or reloaded the policy, and everything is just fine. If I do grab SELinux, it's just fine. Grab SELinux. See, these are all initialized properly. There's no barking about unknown object class, security classes, and there are some barking about context left on a map. These are hard coded in Fedora, but that's no problem. It's just some noise in the log. But anyway, so all the permissions are allowed. So let's just do a journal control. Journal control, I guess. And then go all the way down, and here you have it. So basically, it's just saying unable to get a valid context for root, and this is of course I'm not sure. Now, back. Now, a couple of days ago, I actually filed a bug for Fedora, a couple of weeks ago actually. I filed a bug for Fedora where, and I'm not sure if I removed it, but Fedora, it's actually temporary. Here, PAM SELinux, SSH session, and a couple of others. But those were fixed as far as I know. This one here, where basically I couldn't log in, and it was actually the same shit. Sorry for my, excuse my French, but it's the same error message. And actually I should put it on verbose. I should put it on a verbose man PAM SELinux verbose and debug nano etc PAM D, and then SSHD, I guess, and then put it on verbose verbose debug, and then just try that again, because but actually it might actually not be a it might actually be related to libselinux. Let's just log off. And then do a journal control again. And it actually is able to retrieve the user. So it knows the user, and it knows the level, but it's just unable to get a valid context for root. Where, and we saw that actually, that test U is mapped to test R, and test R has access to system T. So, really, I don't know what's going on, and it's in permissive mode, so I can actually log in. But as soon as I go in enforcing mode, then shit hits the fan. So yeah, it's just really weird. And this is a hard code issue. This is another issue. So I'm guessing that this might actually be a libselinux issue. and not so much a policy issue. Although, if you look in the bug report here, it's basically actually it's the same. It's exactly the same issue here. Jesus, I thought this was fixed. The weird thing is, it doesn't work for login either. So if I try it for login, root abc 123, and the right password, root abc 123, so enable to get valid contacts, and then do a journal control again, then actually the same stuff, unable to get valid contacts. So this might actually just be a libselinux issue actually. So I should basically point this to Walsh. So yeah, but anyways, it boots fine. So if I do a shutdown of get etc as linux config, see it's permissive, so I'll just nano it and set it to enforcing nano enforcing, right, and then shutdown reboot now. Well, as you can see, it's all green, so it's actually, but I can't log in. See, unable to get a valid contact. So that's basically the whole shebang. So yeah, that kind of sucks. So hopefully I'll find a solution for this so that I can actually start writing more complicated policy, because I like the policy, I like the language, I like the syntax and stuff, and it's just very powerful. But yeah, if I can't actually log in, then it's pretty useless. And there's another issue as well, where basically I need a gen home dir con if I want to actually make a policy with user home dirs, and I can use the Python script that was enclosed with a ref policy. I actually do that now, but it's a crappy script. It's and my Python is even is worse, is bad. So I can't actually, well, I might be able to fix it or make it better, but I think that's useless. It would be nice if someone could actually create a standalone gen home dir con command from the libseMANAGE C code. That would be nice if someone would be able to create a small C program, standalone gen home dir con program. And it would be nice not just for me, but also nice for people who want to basically implement a embedded policy, policy for embedded systems using a monolithic policy. It would be nice, because you'll need, if you have local users on your embedded device, then you'll want to actually be able to create home directory contacts, and you can't actually do that because it's integrated in SE module, and SE module actually can't work with monolithic policy. So you need to actually use a standalone gen home dir con utility. And I've been looking at the libseMANAGE code, but it's basically the SEManage gen home dir con function is basically all the way the last thing that gets done when you finish up a transaction. So it's basically hooked into all kinds of stuff, and my C is also very bad, so I'm just not able to do that myself. So anyways, but that's all the info I can give.